Wouldn't it be nice sometimes to grab a cool beverage without the need of visiting your fridge? In this video, I will show you how to achieve this luxury by building a self-made cooler or fridge which can be powered by a car battery if you are into camping. It offers space for 2 half-liter cans and decreases the temperature just below 8 degrees, perfect for a hot day. Let's get started. The main components of this build are so-called Peltier modules. But before going into detail about those, let's firstly talk about thermocouples. Those consist of two different metals which are connected in one point to create a variable voltage in relation to the temperature difference between the connection point and the reference point. This is called Seebeck effect and is used to measure various temperatures. But this also works in the reverse direction. As an experiment, I used thermal paste to bind the side without text of the Peltier module to a small heatsink from an old PC and the other side to an aluminum sheet. If I now apply a small voltage, we can see that current is flowing and the aluminum side gets cold and the heatsink side gets hotter. This is the so-called Peltier effect, but in comparison to thermocouples, we use quite a bit more couples, which this time consists of semiconductors. The text on the front gives us a bit more information about the module itself. This one uses 127 couples and can handle a maximum current of 6 amps. As I was playing around with it at a voltage of 5 volts, I realized that the heatsink on the hot side was certainly too small because it reached a temperature of around 55 degrees. The cold side started with 19 degrees but slowly rose up to 23 degrees since the module can only achieve a certain temperature difference. Meaning that if I would use an active cooling on the hot side, the temperature of the heatsink is lower and I can achieve a lower temperature on the cold side as well. But 14 degrees is still too warm for my drinks, so I reached for my homemade adjustable power supply and tried the same experiment with 12 volts. The results were quite terrible because now the heatsink reaches up to 60 degrees even though I used a fan. The solution was pretty simple. I just got myself an overview of what heatsinks I had available to play around with and chose two old CPU heatsinks. With them, I reached a maximum low temperature of around 7 degrees for the AMD heatsink and even around 5 degrees for the other one. Seems decent enough. But please, don't think this is an efficient way to cool your drinks. If I use the substitute resistance from the datasheet of around 2 ohms, we get a power loss of 32 watts at 12 volts with a current draw of 4 amps. This equals out to an efficiency of only 33.3%. That is terrible. That is why I will use a two-position controller to save a bit of power. This means that I will use an Aduro Nano and a DS18B20 temperature sensor to measure the temperature constantly. Once it reaches a defined low level, like for example 6 degrees, it turns off the Peltier module with a relay. I went with this 2-channel relay board because firstly I want to use two modules later on to cool down things a bit faster. And secondly, it is just cheaper and easier to use this instead of building one on your own. Once the modules are turned off, the temperature increases only slowly due to a hopefully well done thermal insulation. After reaching another defined level, like for example 8 degrees, the modules turn back on again and cool down everything inside the box. This cycle then repeats and will save a bit of power. Before starting the mechanical build though, I wired up the electronics the same way like they will be wired up later, created the simple Arduino code and did a first test try. It may look a bit complicated, but if I break it down with the simplified schematic, then it shouldn't be a problem to reproduce it. Once I was sure everything worked fine, it was time to plan the awesome case. I measured the dimensions of my two cans and came up with a 3-layer design which uses an inner and outer layer of 6mm MDF and a middle layer of 30mm styrofoam. It's a bit of an overkill, but it worked well in the end, which is the main point. I started by marking the measurements for the inner and outer layer onto my piece of MDF and used a jigsaw to cut out the rough shape. Afterwards, I finished all of my necessary MDF pieces with the help of an angle and my découpeur saw. Then I grabbed my overkill styrofoam and marked the middle layer parts onto both sides this time. Trust me, it'll make things easier in a minute. To easily create my styrofoam shapes, I built myself a crude hot wire cutter. I simply measured out a length of 25 cm of the wire and used two wrenches to secure the ends. Then I hooked it up to my power supply, which was set to a constant voltage of 5 volts and reached a high enough temperature to cut the styrofoam. Now the markings on each side makes it a bit easier to use this construction. Once every part was created, I had a closer look at my MDF pieces and realized that they need a bit of rust treatment, which will be finished at the beginning of part 2. Stay tuned for that. Until then, don't forget to like, share and subscribe. Consider supporting me through my Patreon campaign to keep such videos coming. Stay creative and I will see you next time.